Is he the best player in the world right now?
I don't know if he is right now because we've got so many guys injured. But he will now go down in history as a Giant killer. He slayed the Miami Heat when they were on a two-time run. Probably should have been three times, but it was a two-time run with an MVP performance back in 2014. And then last night, and it wasn't just about last night. It was about the whole playoffs and the whole series. Mm-hmm. He slayed the Golden State Warriors, outplayed everybody on the Warriors team, especially those first four games, and takes down another two-time champion, comes into Toronto. And I loved seeing his emotion last night. He let his guard down a little bit. He was very candid after the game, as candid as we've heard from him all year about his issues coming off his injury last year. And at the end of the day, he's got two finals MVP trophies with two different teams and two different conferences, and that's not something that's ever been done. And something else I want to point out, he led the entire playoffs in points, rebounds, and steals. That hasn't been done since Larry Bird in 1984. It was a historically great postseason for Kawhi Leonard.
Of course Kawhi Leonard is the best player in basketball, and it's about time people recognize it. He was the best. With a healthy KD, clearly Golden State would have won, and people would have mistakenly called KD better than Kawhi. Just like with a healthy KD, clearly they destroyed the Cavs last year, and some people mistakenly called KD better than LeBron. LeBron has the postseason to remind us that he's the best in the game usually, because he plays it safe during the regular season, takes his foot off the gas, doesn't spend himself, because he knows the postseason's where it's at. He didn't make the playoffs this year. We won't see him again until the playoffs, so he's almost 36 years old. Who knows? So the title's vacant. That's what I said to start the playoffs. Baton is down. Who wants to pick it up? Kawhi, remember what he did against Philadelphia? Anyone remember the last shot, let alone the series? Remember what he then did to the Greek freak who I thought was going to prove himself the best player in the game? A physical mismatch. And then what he just did to the Golden State Warriors. The most points scored in a single postseason ever, MJ 1, LeBron 2, Kawhi 3. Wendy just brought it up. MVPs with two set finals MVPs, two separate franchises. Kareem, LeBron, now Kawhi. You know who the three greatest players of the modern era are? MJ, Kareem, and LeBron. And Kawhi finds himself on lists with those kind of names. Larry Bird is right there with those kind of names. Everyone always likes to talk about defense. They pay lip service to it. So when I was a kid, they told me Julio Cesar Chavez and Mike Tyson were the best pound for pound in the world. I saw this guy, Pernell Whitaker. I said, well, no one can hit him. Everyone, Felix Trinidad, shame about Floyd Mayweather. No one can hit him. Kawhi plays defense like he's Pernell Whitaker or Floyd Mayweather, but now his offense is almost as good as anyone's in the game. Let me tell you something else, finally. If Kawhi Leonard goes to the Clippers, you heard it here first. The Clippers are winning the NBA title next season.
Oh. Wait. What if AD goes to the Lakers?
If Kawhi goes to the Clippers are your NBA champions.
Stop right there. I have a question. Are you saying if Kawhi Leonard goes by himself or with somebody?
If they keep the team more or less as it is, the pieces, and Kawhi joins by himself as the only superstar, he will do with the Clippers what he just did with the Raptors.
Okay. I just wanted to make sure. before I get into answering that question about the best player in the world, mm-hmm. whether or not that's Kawhi, I want to say this. I feel very, very sorry for the Philadelphia 76ers, because,
right.
My God, could you imagine? I mean, Kawhi was standing in their way. You got to remember, the Sixers blew the Raptors out in two games in that series, forced a game seven, and, the shot by Kawhi that bounced and bounced and bounced before it fell in ultimately derailed the Sixers. Because the Sixers, I'm telling you, somebody that covers the Sixers has been in that locker room, they wanted Milwaukee, and they believed they could have beat Milwaukee. And we see what could have happened to Golden State if you got a collection of talent that you got to deal with. So I feel sorry for the Sixers in that regard, number one. Number two, I also want to say this is a bad day for the San Antonio Spurs. And it's a bad day for the San Antonio Spurs because of Kawhi Leonard's post-game comments. You have to remember, when Kawhi Leonard is alluding to, quote-unquote, people not believing in me, et cetera, think about this. You could talk to media all you want to. All the media did was report.
Yeah.
What was going on inside that locker room.
He kept saying they misdiagnosed his injury,
yes.
Remember?
Not just misdiagnosis, also Tony Parker and other players. Right. And not only that, the belief is that they would not have ever approached him had it not been by, with Greg Popovich giving the okay, et cetera. So we don't know what the truth is in fairness to the San Antonio Spurs, but Kawhi Leonard being as candid as he was in that post game, this is, it's a bad day for the San Antonio Spurs, because not only did you lose him, he basically told you why. You didn't believe in him as a person. It's a bad situation for any organization to be in with a superstar, because you never know how that can affect things moving forward in the future. Now, as it pertains to the best player, Kawhi Leonard, to me, is not the best player in the world. Kawhi Leonard is one of the best players in the world. But to me, I'm not ready to say he's better than LeBron. I damn sure ain't ready to say he's better than Kevin Durant. I'm not even ready to say he's better than Anthony Davis. I don't feel that way.
Hold on, Durant's not going to play next year.
No. I'm just talking about when we say, like what Wendy said when he started off his comments by saying he doesn't know because of the injuries. We're not talking about
what I'm saying is the injuries. You're talking about a 32-year-old by the time he comes back.
That's what you're talking about. I'm talking now. That's what you're talking about. I am saying to you, I'm only looking at talent. I'm not thinking about next year. I understand the injuries when KD might be out. I get all of that. I'm just talking about looking at you right now today. When you analyze somebody's talent and skill set, I don't view Kawhi Leonard as the definitive best in the world. I think LeBron has something to say about that. I think KD, from a talent perspective, has something to say about that. I damn sure think Anthony Davis has something to say about that. Kawhi Leonard is spectacular. He is a superstar. He's a two-time champion, a two-time NBA Finals MVP. I'm not taking anything away from him. But when I think of the skill sets and the talent that it requires, you doing what you do, also making dudes better, playing on both ends of the floor, which obviously is what makes Kawhi Leonard in that conversation. Those three names that I gave you, I think a legitimate argument could be made that all of them could be ahead of Kawhi.
As good as Kawhi was this postseason, believe it or not, the numbers show that LeBron was better last postseason.
Oh, yeah. No, wait.
And granted, the East wasn't as strong,